Welcome back, everybody. Mark here with Exotic Car Play Place. Thanks for coming back to visit the channel, and thanks for listening up on the vlog. Today, I'm going to really quash. Here I am to quash any debate on which car is faster, the BMW E60 M5 with the beautiful V10 motor behind me here, or the F10, which came right after the M5 E60. Which car is faster? A lot of people say the M5 V10 is faster. Some say the twin turbo V8 is faster than the F10. Which one is it really? Let me start out by saying the F10 is 300 pounds heavier. So that's a big disadvantage. That's like throwing a motorcycle in the trunk of your car. That is going to, obviously gonna inhibit some of your performance. Now, you know, I'm looking out here and I'm gonna take this thing for a quick rip. Obviously, I love the M5 on a cold day. Right now, it feels like it's going to rain here right away. It's about 65 degrees Fahrenheit. It's, you know, mid-teens Canadian, you know, in terms of Celsius. So it's not very nice for us, certainly not bathing weather, but it definitely is good for performance driving weather. And so I'm gonna take the M5 for a drive. Now the ultimate question is, which is faster? Here is the debate. Okay, we know that the F10 is heavier. It's a chubby little guy at about 300 pounds more than this thing. 300 pounds more than the E60. Now, there's a difference though. The F10 has 50 horsepower more and 120 foot-pounds torque more. So that is a substantial amount of extra oomph to make that car move down the road. So how does this really equate? At the end of the day, if you're driving down the road, you're going nose to nose, which car is superior in performance? Which is going to win the race? Let's walk this through from a start all the way to the top speed, okay? Now, because the fact that the F10 has a dual clutch transmission, it has twin turbos that spool up relatively quickly due to the modern turbo technology, I'm not going to lie, the F10 will always get off the line faster. Yeah. Just the way it shifts so seamless and it just keeps going. Than the slow shifting SMG transmission found in the E60 here.
Check out the shift speed on this one now.
It's always going to win that little comparison. So from light to light, and even quarter mile, the F10 will win the race, and by a good margin. Then you talk about the next level of speed. So you go from quarter mile, you go past the quarter mile, you're up into those, you know, well into the triple digits, say up to 200 kilometers per hour, you know, 120 miles per hour range. Now, at this point, the F10 is pretty much in full stride and continues to hold that pull that lead on the E60 right behind me here. The F10 will beat the E60 for various reasons, some of which are the additional power, some of which of course are the torque band, because you get that long chubby torque band that you get with the twin turbos, and of course it shifts quicker. So every time you shift, you're shaving seconds or quarter seconds off of each shift. And that, of course, will add up over the course of a race. So the F10 will win in those, you know, up to a reasonable speed. Let's assume that both cars are chipped and we've removed the governors on these cars. This is where the page turns in this book. So when I say, and you ask the question, which car is faster? And I tell you, well, really, they're both faster. Well, I'm not really too far out there by saying that, and you're probably a little confused when I say that, but the reality is they're both faster in different scenarios. Acceleration, pretty much to three-quarter top end, is always going to go to the F10. It's quicker, it's faster, and it just will accelerate faster than the E60 all day long. So that's not the debate. The top end though, however, this is where things start to change. It has been shown time and time again that the E60 M5 will outpull the F10 on the top end. Now, for most of you, it's really not really even an issue to discuss, because nobody really pushes their car to that limits, or seldom, unless you're in Europe and you're happening at the Autostrada or the Autobahn. Very few people will get the opportunity to test this concept. But in reality, the E60 M5 has been shown to pull 204 miles per hour. We're doing well over 330. You're pushing 335 kilometers per hour, close to 340 kilometers per hour on a relatively stock engine, with the exception of a removed governor through a chip. Now, the other point is the F10. The F10, even though it has tons of power, it's the way that that power is delivered, because of the torque and the turbos, it gives you a lot of fat mid-range. But it doesn't have that race engine. It doesn't have that race engine power that pulls right to the peak. So it will not pull as hard at the very, very top of the rev range, like this car will. Everything up to that point, the F10's fast. The E60 though, because what's going to happen as you get close to the top speed, the revs are really high. Well, that's where the peak horsepower comes into play. And because the F1 derived engine in the E60 M5, or the S85 motor in this car, is based on the F1 tech, it pulls right pretty much to the red, where the difference is in the F10, it will not do that. The other thing, of course, is in the F10, the gearing is a little different. Sixth gear is a little bit more of an overdrive gear as well, and unfortunately, that sort of shuts things down. Once the F10 hits about 195 miles per hour, it pretty much shuts down and there's nothing left. The gearing is too long, the torque is there, but there's no horsepower anymore to accelerate that car. Even though you haven't hit the red, the horsepower is not there to escalate it that extra 10, 20 kilometers per hour. And therefore, the E60 M5 right here, this little bad boy, will win the top speed race. This is the true ring taxi. This is the true top speed winner, and is the biggest contender for four-door super saloons that will hit ridiculous speeds that are competitive with anything from the Italian supercar market. Acceleration, the F10. Top speed, the E60. So everyone, I really hope that shared some light on it for you. People seem to be surprised when they see drag races and the F10 pulls ahead on the E60. I'm not surprised, I know that's the case. These cars are a little bit sluggish at the bottom end, and they start building steam as speed kind of comes on. So I hope you enjoyed the video. Make sure you give the channel a like. Comment, of course, below. I'd like to hear your opinion on the whole matter. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Not sure if you know already, but in weeks to follow, I will be doing a draw, and this is going to allow everybody a chance at winning a great giveaway prize coming up soon. So make sure you subscribe, because that's going to give you access. You're going to have visibility on when that next video comes out. But I just want to give you a heads up. Make sure you subscribe now, turn on your notifications, and that way you'll know when that contest begins. So thanks everyone. Talk to you soon. Mark here signing out. Bye-bye.